Hi, this is Bill Carmody with a review of altered dominance. Normally the dominant chord is a major triad, but sometimes to make the voice leading smoother, the fifth of the chord can be raised or lowered a half step. So here we have a G chord that's going to go to a C chord. The fifth can be raised from a D to a D sharp to resolve by half step up to the E of the next chord. Or lowered, the D becomes a D flat to resolve by half step down to the C. If the G chord is going to go to an A minor chord or a C chord with an added sixth, both the third and the fifth could be lowered for smoother half step resolutions down. Half step is smoother than a whole step. So here is are some examples of altered dominants, and you have to spell them out, and we'll do this in class, so prepare ahead of time. Here's an example of altered dominants. Like dominants, they proceed in a circle progression to the tonic. But listen to especially this F double sharp. It sounds so rich and pretty. Great how that F double sharp resolves up a half step to the G sharp. Altered dominants. So in class, since they tend to resolve in circle progressions, here are altered dominant chords, and you have to figure out what key they're in and what chord they're going to resolve to. They're going to resolve down a fifth to a fifth lower than the five chord. The performance of this piece, another example of altered dominance, starts in measure 11. So we're going to start in measure 11, and 12 through 14 are almost identical to measures 16 through 18, which you have here, so you get to hear it twice. And on it goes. Very pretty. Altered dominants are usually used as, can also be used as secondary dominants, or sometimes they're usually used as secondary dominants. The altered notes resolve by half step in their pulling direction. So sharps pull up, flats pull down. As usual, never double an altered tone or a leading tone. So watch out for that. Here's another example of altered dominants. Here she comes.
Plötzlich, da kommt es mir, treuloser Knabe, dass ich die Nacht von dir.
By now, the altered dominants may not sound so altered. You just get used to them resolving down a fifth. These chords are usually in root position. The altered tone should resolve in the direction of the alteration. The resolution, however, may create a doubled third or tripled root. The practice of altering a tone, chord tone, so they can resolve by half step may be applied to any chord in any situation. It doesn't have to be just with dominants. So if you're going to go from one chord to another and one voice is going to go a whole step, you can make it into a half step by changing one of the notes. And they do that to make smooth voice leadings. An inverted altered dominant may duplicate the voicing of an augmented sixth chord. Any chord which has the configuration of an augmented six chord should be analyzed as an augmented six chord and not as an altered dominant. So this first example is an altered dominant, and it has a diminished third between F sharp and A flat. But if the A flat's on the bottom, the F sharp's on the top, now we have an augmented six. Analyze that as an augmented six chord. Here's a exercise for you to take home and work out and turn it in and get graded and see how it goes. All right, here's what it sounds like. Another example that you can analyze to your heart's content. In fact, we'll have you do this in class and analyze it as thoroughly as you can. There are going to be some situations where a chord can be interpreted different ways. So I'll play it for you, that maybe your ear will help you. The first four measures serve as an introduction. The actual melody starts in measure five. This excerpt is a very abridged version of the main theme. Check out some real performances of this tune. They're on YouTube and other places. Harmonies. I love this part. All right, that's it for altered dominants. I hope you understand all that and enjoy. See ya. Bye-bye.